What's happening, everyone? It's Abdallah here, bringing you guys another tips and tricks tutorial video for Yo-Kai Watch Blasters. Today's episode is teaching you guys everything you want to know about Usepion B, arguably one of the best yokai in the game, period. So, by the end of this video, you guys know exactly why I think that, and we're gonna show you guys everything you need to know, such as his endgame stats, we'll show you what kind of sorcery he does, we'll give you some strats and equipment recommendations, and of course, we'll show you guys how to unlock him. So, thanks for watching, and I appreciate all the support that you guys are giving to these tips and tricks tutorial videos. If you guys have any ideas of other ones that you'd like to see, please let me know in the comments. This was definitely one of my most requested ones, simply because we did a live stream of all of Moon Rabbit Crew. You guys can take a look at it on my channel. And every other comment, if you guys missed the how we got it, it was, how did he get Usepion B? How did he get that? So it's relatively simple, but before we jump into how do we get it, let's actually show how good he is, right? What we're gonna do right now is I'm going to unequip him with this thing. He does not need that right now. We're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's take a look at his base stats right off the bat. So, Usepion B is still a B rank, as you guys can see over there. Although this B rank has a strength set of 252. 250 is a very, very high benchmark for attackers. Spirit's 90, HP 400, defense is 106. You don't need your spirit set. HP, sure, it's survivability, and defense is survivability too. His ability though, Sniper, higher chance of criticals based on greater distance. So keep that in mind, it's a brand new way of playing. It's playing at the very, very far outskirts of how you can hit your opponent, which is interesting, and it's perfect for this attacking ranger that we have here. He's a fighter, but he plays like a ranger. It's insane. Anyway, so what we want to also take a look at is he's got Boing Blaster, which is his ultimate. It's pretty much like, yeah, it's exactly like the other B variants, B Jibanyan and Komusan B. So other than that, I do want to take a look at his moves. His moves are very, very good. You can do many different things, and you guys can customize this however you want. What I like to run personally is Charge Shot, so that in case you're kind of waiting around for the boss to show up, you can charge up something really, really strong and then unleash it. And then of course you got Fallback Attack, which is an actual physical attack, but while you attack, you step back and dodge a foe's attack. So you can use this as invincibility frames. There's so many invincibility frames on this, it's not even funny. Dodge is pretty cool. Dodge is exactly like Fallback Attack, but you don't have the attack, and the cooldown's a lot quicker. So you can dodge, and then cooldown for a little bit, and then dodge again. Whereas Fallback Attack, the cooldown is pretty long. And then Vanishing Act, you can bust out like a mini Venoct right over here, where if you pair him up with a specific soul that gives all crits when you're invisible, go for it. That's gonna be awesome for you. Anyway, he's not really built too much for DPS, like damage per second, like Shogunyan and Venoct are, but Vanishing Act can help you out in a pinch. So let's take a look at some equipment recommendations for him. If you guys are all attuned to Yo-Kai Watch news on Twitter and social media, YouTube channel, recaps, all those things, they're gonna give us some QR codes for the Vader chip, and they'll give us QR codes for a brand new blaster for him, which is gonna be his main equip item. Or, if you guys don't wanna wait until that, you guys can absolutely start working on your Oni Smasher Sky, which is definitely one of the end game best, arguably, physical attacking weapons. Simply because you have 400 strength and you're sacrificing HP, yeah, you're gonna be a little bit squishy, but you're gonna hit like a truck. And of course, it has a passive that says increases the power of crits. So you put that on him with his 250, comes 652. And not only that, is you got increased power of crits. So that whenever he crits, it's gonna be a lot stronger. And if you pair him up with a Swell Terrier Soul, increases the power of crits again, so it stacks it even more. So I have yet to boost up my Swell Terrier Soul. Once I get that thing to level 10, you bet I'm gonna have a field day just doing so many powered crits. And of course, if you guys don't have that, you can always run Tanbo Soul, which is also good. This one gives you a higher chance to cause crits. So in case you're not at the farthest length away from the boss and you're kind of in the middle, you'll get a better chance of critting anyway. So that's also very good. We've got him set up with the Swell Terrier Soul right now. So dude, his stats are pretty monstrous with the plus 400. So 652 strength set, keep that in mind. And then of course, comparing him to the other yokai, I mean, you can see over here that base 250 compared to these other guys. Well, I've got them all with equips right now. But anyway, the long story short of it is Usepion B has a lot more attack, and he sacrifices in like all of his other stats. So that's exactly what you want. Okay, so you guys may be wondering, hey Abdallah, how do you go about unlocking him? Well, if you naturally progress through the game, you're going to get him for free. And what I'm gonna do is give you guys a quick tutorial of how exactly to do that. If you guys have already played through the entire game, you've gotten to chapter 11, congratulations, it's really hard to beat Hinozal and Swirlius and all that stuff. But once you get over to the Moon Rabbit Crew exclusive, i.e. by downloading the free update, there's no version that you have to buy, it's absolutely free. Go to the Nintendo eShop, click on updates, or click on settings, then updates, and you're all set. Then, all you have to do is beat 1, 2, and 3 levels in Moon Rabbit Crew Blaster's Wars. You don't have to go over here and beat Momotaro Hunter 2, you don't have to beat Nate the Yokai, and you don't have to beat the Katie map either. You just have to beat 1, 2, 3. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this Usopion team into battle against Captain Thunder over here. We're definitely not going to bring any healers because we're not going to need them. I did bring a couple rice balls in case the going gets tough, so here's hoping that we can do some work against Captain Thunder. Now, in case you guys did not see, we've done a live stream of Moon Rabbit Crew, which was really fun. We did a couple of back-to-back live streams. We had a great time with it. We played every single mission. We beat it all with computer teammates. Minus, like, the gold, the gold claws, dude? Goldie claws? Anyway, let's do this. So, yeah, you'll want to beat this guy, and what we're going to do right now is I'm going to show you exactly how Usopion V plays. As we can see here, if you think of a circle around the boss that you're trying to fight, whenever you press the A button and you don't do any attack, that means that you're outside the circle. If you keep on pressing the A button and you slightly go into the edge of this invisible circle, you're going to be right at the edge of where you want to be. So, with that being said, when you're playing the Usopion V, you want to be spamming the A button as much as you can. Simply because you want to be right on the outside of that circle, right on the inside of the edge of the circle so that you are as far away as possible from whatever boss yokai you were fighting against, and you'll be doing the crazy amount of crits on him. So, anyway, that's exactly what you want to do. You can lock onto him, and then just go from there. If the going gets tough and you feel like you're getting shot at or something like that, feel free, use that dash back attack, and you're gonna do so much. You guys can see I'm doing like 400 damage every shot that I'm doing over here. It's so good. 431. Some of them are not crits. 430, 427, 418, 399. Operation Omega. It's inevitable that he's gonna do that. So, in this particular battle, what he does is he pretty much goes over here and he shoots all of your teammates with all these crazy little orbs. And he'll mix it up based on which yokai he's kind of aiming at. He's not going to go over the same yokai every single time. But anyway, Captain Thunder's just about done right now. Be as far as you can, watch out for his beam attacks, and just be this awesome ranger that you are. So done and done. Mochi's ready. So we got the Mochi done. If you guys have actual teammates other than the CPU, you can go stand on those four little spots next to those Mochi rabbits, and then of course you can stun lock him. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, that's Usopion V. He's really great. I think that he's spot on, arguably one of my top 10 yokai in the game, simply because of his awesome fall back attack. Dude, if Shogunyan had fall back attack, dude, that would be the end. That would be the end. So that's why I like Venok a lot. Venok is really good. He's got fall back attack, he's got the invisibility, he's got a lot of things. I'm not really gonna go ahead and spoil exactly what happens in that cutscene. You guys can go take a look at it. Of course, play Blaster's Wars, you're gonna naturally befriend him and he's gonna be your best friend. So there's a couple more things that I do want to show you guys before we end off the tutorial. The Buster's Usopion is going to be over here. There we go. Let's take a look at his medallion entry, and then we're going to go take a look at Sorcery. So Usopion, in a special suit for Terror Time, features a secret function that allows him to use the hose and enter Emperor Mode. Whoa, Emperor Mode. Uh-oh. All right. So Sniper, high chance for criticals based on greater distance. We saw that. Charge Shot, Dodge, Laser Beam, Boing Blaster, super easy. Vanishing Act, and Fall Back Attack. So really good yokai. Usopion V, man. I like him a lot. Is he someone that you're going to main? I would definitely say so. If you don't really feel comfortable... let's see. I got a B medal. Yeah, dude. If you don't feel comfortable with him... Wow, that's cool. If you don't... Sorry. I'm like looking at this metal. If you're not comfortable with doing melee DPS, like getting right up in any of the enemy's faces, and you're just more like, all right, let me stay back and still contribute. That's why I like Komasan S a lot, since he can kind of stay back and watch the action and contribute as well. So dude, Usepion B against Swirlius and Red Paws, that's great. Him against Shogun King, dude, you're gonna absolutely need him for that. So anyway, great yokai, definitely top 10. Let me know what you guys think about him in the comment section below. I don't know if you guys noticed this, but Sorcery was actually fixed with the brand new update, as we can see right over here. So Sorcery. Now it has the preview screen, which is amazing. We were upset previously in Red Cat Corps and White Dog Squad that you couldn't see unless you actually did the Soultimate. So that's pretty insane. Whoa, forgive me on that one. Anyway, so yeah, you guys can see exactly what's going on over here with all the souls now. You don't have to actually save beforehand, turn him into a soul, and then go from there. So we're going to look at Usepion B. I'm going to show you guys that Usepion B is literally the exact same thing throughout all Usepion variants. Except for this one. Whoa, hold on. Higher chance to cause crits. Wow. Higher chance to cause crits. So that's the same thing as a Tanbo soul. So I guess what you could do is you can sacrifice an Usepion B and put it on, I guess, on Usepion B, like double Usepion B. No, I would totally rock the stronger crit soul. I think that would be a little bit better. So yeah, all the other Usepion variants have the speed up when HP is full, but Usepion B actually is a different yokai entirely. So that's interesting to me. Anyway, if you guys ever want to change your outfits, you guys know this already. Simply put, head on over to the Wayfarer Coliseum, click on this door over here, and you guys can see the Buster's room. Oh, they fixed that. Look, they fixed it. It says Blasters right over here on the ground. In Red Cat Corps, it said Busters, so I thought they were going to keep that little Easter egg there, but they didn't. So you guys can change your outfit at will. You can do change costumes, and then click on Usepion B, and you click on other costumes, and you can go from there. So a little bit later on, we should be able to get all the other Usepion costumes and go from there. It'll be a fun time. So, ladies and gents, that's it. Let me know what you guys think of Usepion B, and I'm curious of which of the three B variants do you like the most? So, Komasan B, Jibanyan B, Usepion B, which one do you guys like the most, and let me know why. I feel the superior one is definitely Usepion B, because he's got custom weaponry, he's got fallback attack, absolutely outstanding. So, thanks for watching. You guys can pick up a shirt right over this way. Make sure you guys are subscribed, turn on your notifications so you're updated on the latest and greatest Yokai Watch content on YouTube, and there's some more playlists on screen. Give those a go, and watch all the tips and tricks videos that I've been making. So, we'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.